During the last week leading up to Friday the 8th of April, detectives from the Organised Crime Squad have been working very closely with Operation Favourtor, which is our joint operation with the AFP, the ACIC being the Australian Criminal Intelligence Commission, and they have been working on our behalf with members of the Homeland Security Department of the United States Government. The inquiries indicated to us that there was serious criminal activity happening in and around the Mascot area, and this activity included money laundering and a supply of drugs. The Organised Crime Squad, in response to that information, commenced a number of surveillance operations and further specialist techniques, which identified two men aged 34 and 39 driving motor vehicles in the vicinity of a block of flats in Gardiners Road at Mascot. Those men were stopped in their cars, and large amounts of cash and drugs were obtained from them at the time of their detention. Following that, two search warrants were executed in the block of units on Gardiners Road, at which time we located a man aged 45 in one of the units, and further searching identified large amounts of cash, drugs, documents and other items connected to money laundering. A further search warrant was then executed on a self-storage unit, at which time we found a number of items, including ATM machines used to change cryptocurrency into cash. By the end of the operation, we seized in excess of $4.7 million cash, 5 kilograms of drugs, including heroin, methamphetamine and cocaine, substantial documents linking this group to members of overseas crime groups, or we will allege, of course, and the machinery linked to the handling of cryptocurrency. This is a spectacular success for Australian law enforcement in partnership with our overseas partners. No organised crime team in the world now can exist without working in an international sense. It shows the connectedness of the world drug market into Australia, and these various drug teams working together have achieved this outstanding result. Of note, this was the first major example we've found of what you could describe as a vertically integrated drug operation, that being the importation of prohibited drugs from overseas, the processing, refining of those drugs into usable quantities, and then the retail sale of those drugs, we'll allege, to customers all around Australia through the postal network. Once those sales were made, we will allege, utilising cryptocurrency and encrypted telephones, which you would be aware of through Operation Ironside, continue to be a threat to our community. They then converted those monies into cash, and that cash has then been laundered through various networks back overseas to continue the cycle of importation of dangerous drugs in our community. The three men have been charged with serious offences, including supplying a large commercial quantity of drugs, processing and handling the proceeds of crime, and other various offences, which we'll continue to investigate, including the offences surrounding the use of the ATMs, which will have certain serious breaches of Commonwealth law. The partnership, as I said, between the different agencies was seamless in this occasion and allowed us to make these seizures. We would certainly like to ask the community if they have any information to assist us with this by calling Crime Stoppers on 1-800-333-000. There are people who are expecting drugs to be supplied to them this week through the mail. They won't be arriving, and they may be getting visits from police. So they may wish to come and see us first. Certainly like to take any questions. One of the men, we will allege, was in possession of a box full of postal envelopes addressed to people throughout Australia, and within those envelopes, we allege, were drugs secreted for postage through the mail. So he was undertaking that process. Other gentlemen just had money in his car. We're not quite sure what he was up to at that stage.
Will you be tracking down those people on the mailing list?
Yes, we have a very detailed list of the recipients of those parcels. And we'll certainly be making inquiries, and we've already started those inquiries with our interstate partners. So this could well be an investigation that involves nearly every jurisdiction in Australia, plus the overseas partners in the United States, as we stated.
How does this syndicate compare to further or previous arrests recently as part of the
Ironside as well? Well, since Operation Ironside exposed the scale of drug trafficking, money laundering, we've made a number of significant arrests. The Organised Crime Squad alone in New South Wales has seized in excess of $17 million cash this year, which we'll allege is money that was to be laundered through through various sources to go back overseas and purchase drugs. Whilst the quantity of drugs, whilst serious, 5 kilograms is a very, very serious amount, is less than some other seizures. As I said, this is the first time we've seen this detailed vertical integration business model from the importation of the commodity to the on-supply to customers and then the laundering of the proceeds at the end. The laundering of cash remains a serious threat to our economy, deprives our taxation system of money that should be going to our schools, roads and hospitals. And we will maintain absolute focus on this with our partners.
The third man arrested, was he just there? Were you looking to arrest that third man, or was he just quickly there and you made that arrest?
The interesting thing with this job is we were given a number of pieces of information, but we're really, the inquiries conducted by my detectives identified these extra players, I'm afraid. The gentleman that was in the unit was arrested and charged and later found to be named in a number of arrest warrants for also serious drug offences in the past. So we're still working on how he's fitted into the syndicate completely, but it's certainly a line of inquiry that he